just, so it's not intended to offend, but I just wanted to put it out there anyway. So when I was a child, all of the love songs were written to God, that glorious, unfathomable, unknowable entity to whom we all prayed lovingly and adoringly, daily and nightly, with words beautiful, aching, plump with desire and throbbing with intensity, describing so delicately that indefinable, unrequitable impossibility of ever uniting your soul with the soul of your beloved. Soul lover, tender father, draw me into your desire. My soul is sick with loving you. Heal me with the act of loving you. There was something so homoerotic about it all. These old, bearded, religious men gushing like teenagers to a deity that they called him. Clothed in masculine symbology, draped in the patriarchal ideology. His sword was bloody, his robes were crimson. His voice was the howling of the lonely desert winds. His voice would shatter his enemies before him. Him, 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 him. Not that there's anything wrong with that, obviously. But clearly, there was a severe lack of vaginas in all of the religious imagery. You see, the God of my childhood didn't have a pussy. Only one large, holy cock that was there to penetrate every single aspect of your lives, thrust into it blindly, stretching, tearing, and fill it entirely. Love me exclusively, said the invisible sky god embodying toxic masculinity. But it wasn't always this way. You see, once upon a time, the Mother Goddess held sway across vast regions of the human mind known as Ishtar and Durga and Pachamama and Gaia. You see, way, way back in earlier times, the association of the feminine with the divine was something everyone clearly recognized. Incredibly non-controversial. It was just a reflection of the true nature of things because clearly, there's at least a masculine and a feminine. You see, religion is not the problem. It's patriarchal religion, totalitarian religion. Religions based on dogma and text. Text is the most masculine thing, stuck there on a page, immovable, unbending. Unlike the spoken word that moves and shimmers, carries tone and inflection, let's make religion vaginal again. Because gender isn't a binary. We're all on a spectrum, you see, and there's a little bit of boy and girl inside of all of us. So we need our religions to embrace all of us and the all of us, not a dogma or a text, because God isn't genderless. God is genderful. And we all create the energy that's spiritual, that teaches the heart how to love, the mind how to rest, how to look at the world and always see the best, because let's face it, all of us. Oppressed and repressed and lost in this mess. So all I'm trying to say is no one has to throw God away. Just return the Mother Goddess to her rightful place and let's make religions vaginal again.